It's easy. May 10, 1965. Then I come back here and I'm a billionaire. Is there such a thing as a trillionaire?
That's it, honey.
What else?
Nothing you'd change.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Thanks, Brian.
So, how's James holding up?
We're taking it one day at a time.
Well, grief moves at its own pace. So.
Listen, my brother Chuck, he loved me in his own way. He loved me as a brother. He did not love me as a lawyer.
You're gonna call yourself Saul Goodman?
Saul Goodman.
When did you decide?
Just now, he's back there. Just boom, it just hit me. Next. This is the way, Kim. It's gonna work. I can't go back to being Jimmy McGill.
Well, tell me about Saul Goodman. If he's not Jimmy McGill, who is he?
Jimmy McGill, the lawyer, is always going to be Chuck McGill's loser brother. Saul Goodman is he's the last line of defense for the little guy. He's a writer of wrongs. He's a friend to the friendless.
Couldn't Jimmy McGill do all that?
I have a new client. He's connected. I mean, he's a cartel guy. He said I'd be a friend of the cartel. But
do you want to be a friend of the cartel?
It's not about what you want. When you're in, you're in.
Then you're the guy, right?
What guy's that?
Salamanca's guy.
What have I gotten myself involved with here?
Jimmy, you are an attorney, not a bad man.
Time to get yourself a new motto.
There's no amount of money that is worth this.
Just make money.
Enemigo del cartel! Enemigo del cartel!
All this shit. So he can get out of jail and just get away.
Jimmy. Oh my God.
Jimmy, I'm sorry you're in pain.
You're sorry. You kill my brother and you say you're sorry.
You have no idea what's going on. You're a teensy tiny man in a teensy weensy little bubble.
Jimmy.
Oh, don't you fucking old Jimmy me. You look down on me, you pity me. I travel in worlds you can't even imagine. You can't conceive of what I'm capable of. I'm so far beyond you. I'm like a god in human clothing. Lightning bolts shoot from my fingertips.
Kim, when I was out there, I didn't think I was gonna make it. I was that close to giving up. And the only thing that kept me going was knowing that you were here. I'm okay. Am I bad for you?
Are you bad for me?
None of this would have happened if you weren't with me.
You and I both know it makes no sense to drop a client like Mesa Verde. And I gotta think Jimmy had something to do with that.
Oh, that helped me to see what's important, what isn't.
What if Howard does something terrible?
You know what that'd mean for the Sandpiper case?
We could tank the whole thing. Kim, doing this, it's not you. Okay. You would not be okay with it.
Wouldn't I?
There are wolves and sheep in this world, kid.
Figure out which one you're gonna be.
The Howard thing. What were you thinking?
Well, it has to be paced right.
To get a bunch of lawyers to run for the exits, Howard would have to have done something unforgivable.
Jesus.
At the end of it, he might never be able to practice law again.
Action again!
We're talking about a career setback. A career setback for one lawyer.
Is that supposed to be me?
They've been switched. Somehow he switched them. He snuck in somehow, and these are not the pictures I saw.
A couple months from now, there are people whose lives are going to be way better because of this. We're doing the Lord's work here.
You two. You two are soulless. Jimmy, you can't help yourself. Chuck knew it. You were born that way. But you, one of the smartest and most promising human beings I've ever known. And this is the life you choose.
We had a monster in custody. We just let him walk right out of jail. It's wrong. You know it's wrong.
How? He scammed the court. He scammed the judge. And for what? To get a murdering cartel psychopath back out on the street? It's just wrong.
There's really no need, John.
Friend of the cartel, right?
We all make our choices.
Gotta go.
And those choices, they put us on a road. And the road we're on led us out to the desert and straight back to where we are right now. And nothing, nothing can be done about that.
Jimmy! You asked if you were bad for me. That's not it. We are bad for each other. We are bad for everyone around us. Other people suffer because of us. It is a lie. You lie. I lie.
Mike told you that all of us lie. And you didn't tell me.
The real reason I didn't tell you was because I knew what you'd do. You'd want us to run and hide until you were sure I was safe. You would pull the plug on the scam, and then we'd break up. And I didn't want that. Because I was having too much fun.
You are not talking about a time machine.
You are talking about regrets. So if you want to ask about regrets, just ask about regrets.
Wait, I got one.
A slip and fall.
Yeah, that's how I put myself through bartending school.
So, you were always like this.
You know, I could hire someone to do this. I could get someone from the office.
I'm doing it.
Yeah, every day? While you're trying to start a practice? Why?
Why? Because you're my brother. You'd do the same for me.
James M. McGill, a lawyer you can trust.
Helping my clients, you know, arguing on their behalf, that's the best thing I've ever done.
I know you. I know what you were, what you are. People don't change. You're slipping Jimmy.
Why are you acting like this?
I'm not acting like anything. I just finally decided to be me.
I mean, they'll smile at you, they'll pat you on the head, but they are never, ever letting you in. You're gonna go your own way, you're gonna do what they won't do. You're gonna be smart, you are gonna cut corners, and you are gonna win.
Guys like you, you think you're so damn smart,
and you think you don't have to play straight with anybody, the wheel is going to turn. It always does.
Why have regrets at all? What's the point? You're just going to keep hurting people. Jimmy, this is what you do. You hurt people over and over and over, and then there's this show of remorse.
If I die tonight, no one would care.
You're good influence, Jim.
Jimmy McGill reached out to people who otherwise may never have seen an attorney in their entire lives. Because Jimmy McGill cares about people.
Just tell me what to do. Tell me what I need to do to change. Whatever it is, I'll do it.
You should turn yourself in.
There you go. Kick him in when he's down.
Jimmy, you are always down.
This guy, any good?
Have a nice life, Kim.
When I knew him, he was.
I think that can't be much. So we're back in business? Suck. I trusted you.
You know who really knew Jimmy? Chuck.
They tell me they found you in a garbage dumpster. Well, that makes sense.
Sounds like you and your ex aren't talking on a regular basis.
She spilled her guts about Howard Hamlin. On the record.
Why are you doing this?
You're slipping, Jimmy. What do you gotta change, huh?
What more are you gonna get? What's left?
You don't understand. It's really good ice cream.
Jimmy, whatever happens in there, I'm with you.
If you don't like where you're heading, there's no shame in going back and changing your path.
What happened to Howard Hamlin? I can't even. After that, Kim had the guts to start over. I'm the one who ran away. And my brother Chuck, the most brilliant guy I ever met, but he was limited. I tried. I could have tried out. I should have. Instead, when I saw a chance to hurt him, I took it. I got his malpractice insurance canceled. I took away the one thing he lived for, the love. That he killed himself. And I'll live with that.
86 years.
86 years. But with good behavior, who knows? The name's McGill. I'm James McGill.